أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأصلي وأسلم صلاة وتسليما يليقان بسيد الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم لا سهل إلا ما جعلته سهلا، وأنت تجعل الحزن سهلا إذا شئت. يسر لنا أمورنا كلها يا أكرم الأكرمين، واكتب لنا الخير والسداد، إنك على ما تشاء قدير. اجعل القرآن الكريم ربيع قلوبنا ونور أبصارنا وجلاء همنا وذهاب حزننا. اللهم علمنا منه ما جهلنا، وذكرنا منه ما نسينا، وارزقنا تلاوته آناء الليل وأطراف النهار على النحو الذي يرضيك عنا يا أكرم الأكرمين. آمين آمين. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, we will continue inshallah ta'ala interpretation the verses from Surah Al Imran. Verse 114, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ليسوا سواء من أهل الكتاب أمة قائمة يتلون آيات الله are a portion that stand for the right. They rehearse the signs of Allah all night long, and they prostrate themselves in adoration. يؤمنون بالله واليوم الآخر ويأمرون بالمعروف وينهون عن المنكر ويسارعون في الخيرات وأولئك من الصالحين. They believe in Allah and the last day. They enjoin what is right and forbid what is wrong. And they hasten in all good works. They are in the ranks of the righteous. وَمَا يَفْعَلُوا مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَلَنْ يُكْفَرُوهُ. Of the good that they do, nothing will be rejected of them, for Allah knows well those that do right. وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِالْمُتَّقِينَ. إن الذين كفروا لن تغني عنهم أموالهم ولا أولادهم من الله شيئا. Those who reject faith, neither their possessions nor their progeny will avail them aught against Allah. وَأُولَٰئِكَ أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ. They will be companions of the fire, dwelling therein forever. مَثَلُ مَا يُنْفِقُونَ فِي هَذِهِ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. What they spend in the life of this material world may be likened to a wind. كمثل ريح فيها صر أصابت حرث قوم ظلموا أنفسهم فأهلكت. هم يظلمون may be likened to a wind which brings a nipping frost. It strikes and destroys the harvest of men who have wronged their own souls. It is not Allah that hath wronged them, but they wrong themselves. This is the closest translation for those verses, but inshallah we'll try to understand those verses better. The verses that we have listened to describes the way of the people of the book. But we would like to know in this verse, whom are the people of the book in this verse? Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu has narrated a little story about the revelation of those verses. That Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam one day he postponed Isha prayer till the midnight. When he came to the masjid to pray Isha, he found so many people are waiting for him. And he said to them, at this time, nobody from other religions is awake and is doing what you are doing of the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then نزل قوله تعالى ليسوا سواء. They are not equal or alike. Some people of the book are different from others. العلماء الكرام, some of the scholars of Islam said Allah meant in this ayah that the people of the book are the Muslims, not the Christians or Jews. بدليل هذا الحديث, and this hadith or narration by Ibn Mas'ud is the main evidence that Allah is praising or describing the situation of Muslims who are in the mid of night are waiting to pray behind Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. At that time, nobody people, not too many people in the whole world are trying to please Allah or worship Him. فيقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ليس من أهل هذه الأديان أحد يذكر الله هذه الساعة غيركم غيركم. There is no one from the people who are belong to different religion are remembering Allah at this time except you. So the ulama said, so when the revelation came, that means Allah is describing this group, the people of the book, means the Muslims. لكن المشهور عند أهل العلم أن هذه الآية تصف جماعة من أهل الكتاب, أي من اليهود والنصارى. But the famous opinion about this revelation is the real people of the book, means the Christian and Jews. Some of them are good and they remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وذكر العلماء من هؤلاء سيدنا عبد الله بن سلام الرجل اليهودي. The scholars of Islam mentioned the name of Abdullah ibn Salam and Asad ibn Ubayd and Usayd ibn Sa'yah. The three of them originally were Jews. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam arrived to Al-Madinah al-Munawwara, immigrating from Mecca, they met him. Especially Abdullah ibn Salam, he found on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, found out that he is the real Prophet. Because he read about the seal of the Prophet, he eats with his right hand, he says Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, he says Alhamdulillah if he finished eating. So he discovered his shoulder and he found Khatm al-Nubuwa. He found the seal of al-Nubuwa, the prophecy, on the shoulder of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he heard from the Prophet is saying this hadith. Abdullah ibn Salam narrated this hadith from the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام that the best عمل is إطعام الطعام وطيب الكلام والصلاة بالليل والناس نيام. Abdullah ibn Salam said, the first thing I heard from the Prophet peace be upon him when he just arrived to Al-Madinah is saying that the best action is to say good words and to pray at night and to feed the food to the people who are hungry. أفضل الأعمال إفشاء السلام. The fourth thing is to say السلام عليكم. إفشاء السلام وطيب الطعام وطيب الكلام وإطعام الطعام والصلاة بالليل والناس نيام. I heard from the Prophet is saying أيها الناس, أيها الناس, O people, أفشوا السلام, say السلام عليكم to everyone, وأطعموا الطعام and feed the food to the people who need that. وصلوا بالليل والناس نيام, pray at night while some people are sleeping. تدخل الجنة بسلام. You will enter الجنة with peace. أيها الناس أفشوا السلام وأطعموا الطعام وأطيبوا الكلام وصلوا بالليل والناس نيام تدخل الجنة بسلام. And سيدنا عبد الله بن سلام, he was the one narrated this hadith from the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, and he said that was the first thing I heard from the Prophet, so I knew he is the Prophet of God and I have converted to Islam after that. So we can say that some people of the book are very good, like Abdullah ibn Salam and Sayyiduna Asad ibn Ubayd wa Usayd ibn Sa'd. The three of them have converted to Islam when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam just arrived to Al-Madinah al-Munawwarah. According to this hadith, we can say that Allah meant by this ayah, لَيْسُ سَوَاءَ, they are not equal. Some people of the book are good and some are not. So you as a Muslim, you have to be fair. من أهل الكتاب من إن تأمنه بقنطار يؤده إليك، ومنهم من إن تأمنه بدينار لا يؤده إليك. Another evidence can support this interpretation that the people of the book in this ayah, the Christian and Jews, is the other evidence that some people you can give them so much money and they are trustworthy. They bring you your money after years and years. They do not cheat. And some of them, لا إن تأمنه بدينار لا يؤديه إليك إلا ما كنت عليه قائما. Some of them, if you trust them with $1, they cheat. And they don't give it to you back until you keep asking them, please, I need your money. So you can see the difference. قنطار, قال أهل العلم, is 1,000 gold, 1,000 kilogram of gold. And they protect it for you. And the other one, for $1, they cheat. So you as a Muslims, you have to be fair. You have to give the right judgment. You can't always say these people are bad because they don't convert to Islam. Some of them are good. Some of them are very close. Because of that, we have one type of Ahlul Zakah. It's called وَالْمُؤَلَّفَةُ قُلُوبُهُمْ إِنَّمَا الصَّدَقَاتُ لِلْفُقَرَاءِ والمساكين والعاملين عليها والمؤلفة قلوبهم والغارمين وفي سبيل الله وابن السبيل فريضة من الله. So we give eighth of our zakah to one type of people, المؤلفة قلوبهم, those who are thinking of goodness, thinking of Islam. They do not harm you, they do not insult you. So there are people good in every society, in every time. So you as a Muslim, be fair. In the same, that was the second evidence, tells you that the people of the book means the Christian and Jews. Another evidence, in the same surah, in the end of it, وَإِنَّ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ لَمَنْ يُؤْمِنُ بِمَا أُنْزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ وَإِنَّ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ لَمَنْ يُؤْمِنُ بِمَا أُنْزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ وَمَا أُنْزِلَ إِلَيْهِمْ. Some people of the book, they believe in what has been revealed on you and what has been revealed on them. وَمَا أُنْزِلَ إِلَيْهِمْ خَاشِعِينَ لِلَّهِ لَا يَشْتَرُونَ بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ ثَمَنًا قَلِيلًا. They have خَشْيَة, they fear Allah, and they do not sell their deen, their conscience, for very cheap price. أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ. These people, they shall get their reward from Allah. They are eligible to get their reward from Allah. They are the people of the book. That's another evidence. Another evidence also, fourth one, many, many verses. So sometimes the Christian or Jews, they challenge us what the Quran said about us. That what is the Quran is saying about you, about the good people. ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ مِنْهُمْ قِسِّيسِينَ وَرُهْبَانًا وَأَنَّهُمْ لَا يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ. Because some people of the book are good. Why? Because among them, priests, they tell them the right thing. Some of the priests are good. They tell them the truth. Sometimes, some of the priests, they cannot follow. Like Al-Najashi, he was afraid of his people, the king of Abyssinia. So he didn't like to convert to Islam in front of his people. He feared his people. But finally he converted. أن قال لسيدنا جعفر إن الذي جاء به محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم والذي جاء به عيسى بن مريم لا يخرجان من مشكاة واحدة. I swear by God's name. النجاشي السيد جعفر when he read سورة مريم on him, he said, I swear by Allah's name that what you have recited and what has been revealed on Jesus, peace be upon him, both of revelation came from one source, from one source of light, Mishkat. From what place? فقالوا فنخر بطارقته. So the people around him said, they said like that. He's going to be Muslim. قال لهم وإن نخرتم. Even though if you say bad things, I'm saying the truth. So Allah said about him and about other people, about the priests, the good priests. ذلك بأن منهم قسيسين ورهبانا. The reason that some people are good, because amongst them, good priests, when they hear the Holy Quran, they cry. وَإِذَا مَا سَمِعُوا إِلَى مَا أُنْزِلَ إِلَى الرَّسُولِ تَرَى أَعْيُنَهُمْ تَفِيضُ مِنَ الدَّمْعِ مِمَّا عَرَفُوا مِنَ الْحَقِّ. And you see some of them are crying. You see the tears coming from their eyes because they know that the Quran is the true revelation from God, the original words of Allah. Because of that, we still respect many people who say the truth, who do not insult, who know the goodness and differentiate bad from good. Why not? We respect them and we should be good to them. Because of the fifth evidence from the Holy Quran, لا ينهاكم الله عن الذين لم يقاتلوكم في الدين. Allah does not stop you from being good with those who are not fighting you because of your religion. ولم يخرجوكم من دياركم, and those who does not force you to leave your country. ولم يظاهروا على إخراجكم, and they do not support the people who fight you and force you to leave your country. وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُقْسِطِينَ, and Allah loves the people of justice. إِنَّمَا يَنْهَاكُمُ اللَّهُ عَنِ الَّذِينَ قَاتَلُوكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ. But Allah stop you from being good with the people who are fighting you because you are saying the truth and because you are believing in the truth. إنما ينهاكم الله عن الذين قاتلوكم في الدين وأخرجوكم من دياركم, and they forced you to leave your country, وظاهروا على إخراجكم, أن تولوهم, and you follow them. Allah does not like you to follow them, and Allah does not like the oppressors. وَمَنْ يَتَوَلَّهُمْ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. And whoever follow them, if they are going astray, that means those people who are following الظالمين are ظالمين or oppressors like them. So when you read the Quran, you see the difference. Always good and bad. In every ummah, in every nationality, in every state. So Muslim has to be fair in his, her judgment. Always like that. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is describing here the people of the book according to the reason of the revelation. The ayat describes Muslims, because also we are people of book, because we have the Quran. In another opinion, ulama said, because most of the ayat talk in the Quran about the people of the book means al-Yahud wal-Nasara, the Christian and Jews. So in this verse, the strongest opinion is al-Yahud wal-Nasara, some people of the book. Minhum, أمة قائمة يتلون آيات الله. People are standing and reciting the verses of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. آناء الليل وهم يسجدون. The whole night and they are prostrating, making sujood to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Another character for them. يؤمنون بالله واليوم الآخر. They believe in God and the day of judgment. Both Christian and Jews, they believe in the day of judgment. Some of them, they believe in God alone. Some of them, they believe in God, but they associate with God another partner. وقالت اليهود عزير بن الله وقالت النصارى المسيح ابن الله. The Jews said, as the Quran describe it, they said Al-Uzair is the son of God. And the Christians said Jesus is the son of God. قالت النصارى المسيح ابن الله. And that both are wrong. ما اتخذ الله صاحبة ولا ولدا. Allah does not associate friend or son. قل هو الله أحد. Say Allah is the one alone. Allah الصمد. He is the master of everything and forever. لم يلد ولم يولد. He was not born like by somebody else. And does not give the birth. وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ. And nobody is equal to Allah. Whoever believes that Allah needs helpers or associate with him partners, he or she is mushrik. Rejecting the right belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But some people are good. As I said, they believe in Allah and the last day, the day of judgment. يَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. They enjoin what is right and forbid what is wrong. وَيُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ. They like to do goodness. And they are the people of righteous or believe in or practice righteousness. Many people like that. I told you about the story last time when Sayyidina Umar قال نحن أحق بالعدل من كسرى. كسرى, the king of Birgel, he did something good with a lady has land, and he did not build the place of birth on her land while he needs it badly. Otherwise, the church will be curved. So he kept it like that, and he did not take the land of the lady. So when the Muslims opened at Damascus, and they wanted to build the mosque on some people's land, Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu got angry, and he did not like people to do anything wrong or to take the right of the others. قال نحن أحق بالعدل من كسرى. We are the people of justice. And I told you that Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu, he refused when the priest of Al-Qiyamah in Jerusalem asked him and honored him to enter the church and to pray in it, he visited him, but he refused to pray inside the church. Not because the church is a bad place. جُعِلَتْ لِيَ الْأَرْضُ مَسْجِدًا مُطَهُورًا. You can pray in any place you like, as long as the place is purified. But Sayyidina Umar, as a leader, if he prayed inside the church, the Muslims later will claim that the church for them. And he did not like that to happen, to take the rights of the others. So till now you can see the church of Al-Qiyamah beside the farthest mosque, Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa, side by side. Nobody touch it. And there is a special place I heard, I never seen the Kinesat Al-Qiyamah from inside, but I heard that there is a special place till this moment beside the Kinesa is guarded by the Christians, and nobody has right to go to pray in that place until takes the permission from the priest over there. This is the place that Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu prayed there. So there's so much respect between the church and the mosque, especially when people respect each other and the revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and some of them, they know the truth. So you have to treat them kindly. لأن الله عز وجل قال أن تبروهم ليس لا ينهاكم الله عن الذين لم يقاتلوكم في الدين ولم يخرجوكم من دياركم ولم يظاهروا على إخراجكم أن تبروهم وتقسطوا إليهم إن الله يحب المقسطين. Allah has mentioned the birr in the Quran in more than one place only for the parents, treating them kindly. And in the fourth or the fifth place in the Holy Quran is to the people of the book, if they respect you and respect your religion, you have to treat them kindly, extra kind, as the verse in Surah Al-Mumtahina said. أَن تَبَرُّوهُمْ وَتُقْسِطُوا إِلَيْهِمْ. Be fair with them. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُقْسِطِينَ. Allah loves just and people of justice. That is important. We have to keep it in our minds. And if we really understood this carefully, we can lead the whole world to a salam, to peace, and to an Islam. But when we understand that carefully. So as the Quran said, لَيْسُوا سَوَاءً. They are not alike. Not equal. وَمَا يَفْعَلُوا مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَلَنْ يُكْفَرُوهُ. The true people, if they did good, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not oppress them, Allah will reward them for that. But if they are doing good with shirk, Allah does not.
وَقَدِمْنَا إِلَى مَا عَمِلُوا مِنْ عَمَلٍ فَجَعَلْنَاهُ هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا.
For those who do not believe in God, if they did good and they know the truth, they won't be rewarded for that. لِأَنَّ الْمَطْلُوبُ مِنْهُمْ لَيْسَ الصِّيَامُ وَلَا الصَّلَاةُ وَهُمْ مُشْرِكُونَ. إِنَّمَا الْمَطْلُوبُ مِنْهُمُ الْإِسْلَامُ أَوَّلًا. So you have to use the key of Islamic gate, which La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, and then you can do inside the castle whatever you like after you enter. But some people ask me in Ramadan, they like to fast with Muslims, but they like to stay non-Muslims. I say it's good deal. But it's up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if He won't reward you or not. يعني الله يقول وقدمنا إلى ما عملوا من عمل صالح فجعلناه وباء مقدورا. الله does not accept good deeds from one who associates with Allah any partner. وسئل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عن أعظم الذنوب قال أن تجعل لله ندا وهو خلقك. The major sin, the biggest major sin that person can commit is when you associate with Allah partner while you know that he has no partner, while you know that he has created you. أعظم الذنوب أن تجعل لله ندا وهو خلقك وأن تقتل ولدك خشية أن يطعم معك. And the second major sin is when you kill your son because you don't like him to eat with you. It doesn't mean to kill him physically in this hadith. Some people, they make abortion. That is kind of killing. It is not allowed in Islam. The abortion is not allowed in Islam. Except if mother, the life of the mother is very risky. Very risky. Some people ask me this question, that it's okay to have abortion before 3 months. They think it's okay and lawful, but it's not okay after. It's haram completely from day one. But there is difference between the 3 months and more than 3 months. After the 3 months, قتل نفس. It's killing of soul, of life. But before the 3 months is a crime. And is major sin. That's the difference. لأن قتل النفس فيها الدية. لأنه نفخ فيه الروح. هذه قتل نفس. لكن قبل نفخ الروح جريمة أيضا. So both of them crime. But after 3 months, because this life is a life, is a soul, is a human being. And if somebody did abortion for that fetus, it's like killing nafs, killing soul. It's haram. It's major sin. Both of them is haram, but هذا فيه الدية وهذا ليس فيه الدية. The second one, the major one, people have to pay a dia. You know, a dia, when somebody kills somebody else by mistake. In Islam, they have to pay a dia like it was 100 camel at that time, the full dia. But that by mistake, not in purpose. In purpose, فجزاؤه جهنم. وما كان لمؤمن أن يقتل مؤمنا إلا خطأ. مؤمن has no right to kill another mu'min or another soul except by mistake. And in another verse, ومن قتل مؤمنا متعمدا فجزاؤه جهنم. Whoever killed a mu'min in purpose, that penalty for that is Jahannam, but by mistake is Addiya. Addiya tuqaddar. We estimate Addiya in every century and in every time, in every place. But it was at the time of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam and after 100 camel. And the camel is valuable to Arab people at that time. So it's something huge. Big. So a dia, if somebody did the abortion, it could be dia for no reason, for no excuse. But because al-Islam respects the life, The life of the mother is very important, more important than the fetus or the child. So if the life of the mother is risky, yes, she can have that. That is the excuse. If there is no excuse, no disease, no sickness, nothing, no risk, it's haram.
إن الذين كفروا لن تغني عنهم أموالهم ولا أولادهم من الله شيئا.
Those who disbelieved in God, they won't have anyone in the day of judgment to protect them from the punishment of God. Not their money, nor their children. Can help father and mother at all. So Allah is comparing between the people of the book and the kuffar, those who rejected the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so their children cannot help them in the day of judgment. I'll tell you about the closest person to the Prophet, peace be upon him, who was Abu Lahab. You know that he's the uncle of the Prophet.
لما علم أن جزاء الكافرين النار قال إذا كان الدين حق واليوم الآخر حق فأنا أفتدي نفسي بمالي.
Abu Lahab said, if the religion of Islam is true and there will be last day, which is the day of judgment, there will be Jannah and Nar, I can protect myself with my money because I have so much money. The revelation came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Tabbat yada Abi Lahabin wa tab. ما أغنى عنه ماله وما كسب سيصلى نارا ذات لهب وامرأته حمالة الحطب في جيدها حبل من مسد.
أبو لهب will be going to hell. And he was called Abu Lahab because he used to make special fire to stop al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from conveying the da'wah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called him Abu Lahab, the flame, the father of the flames.
مَا أَغْنَى عَنْهُ مَالُهُ وَمَا كَسَبُ.
He said, I have so much money, I can buy al-Jannah, the paradise, with my money and protect myself from hell. Allah said, مَا أَغْنَى عَنْهُ مَالُهُ وَمَا كَسَبُ. His money won't do any good for him at that time.
سَيَصْلَى نَارًا ذَاتَ لَهَبٍ.
He shall go to hell. And the description of the fire is with so much flames. ذَاتَ لَهَبٍ.
Himself and his wife, وَمْرَأَتُهُ, the one she used to carry the wood and make the fire in front of the Prophet, peace be upon him,
Ummu Jamil. She's very known in the history of Islam. Ummu Jamil, the wife of Abu Lahab, she used to make special fire, huge fire, to stop al-Nabi from going from here or from there. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Abu Lahab and his wife shall go to hell in the day of judgment.
No, none of his children will help him, nor his money can protect him.
So Allah is saying here the same thing. إن الذين كفروا لن تغني عنهم أموالهم ولا أولادهم من الله شيئا وأولئك أصحاب النار هم فيها خالدون. They are the people of hell and they will go rejected the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah is comparing between the good people and the bad people. Another similitude for them.
مَثَلُ مَا يُنْفِقُونَ فِي هَذِهِ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا.
The similar situation of their spending of money in this life, or the similitude of the unbelievers while they are spending money just for liyasuddu an sabilillah, to stop people from following the deen of Allah. فَسَيُنْفِقُونَهَا ثُمَّ تَكُونُ عَلَيْهِمْ حَسْرَةً ثُمَّ يُغْلَبُونَ. They spend money and they will regret and they will be defeated. وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا إِلَى جَهَنَّمَ يُحْشَرُونَ. And their generosity, the unbeliever's generosity, is like somebody has very nice farm. Allah is saying in the Holy Quran. And he has so much wheat, plants, fruits. And when he was about to get them, the time of harvest, the farm, then the wind came, mixing with hail, snow, ice, and they burned his fruit. They burned it. Because when the ice touches the fruit, it burns it like fire. كمثل ريح فيها صر فيها برد هي wind mixed with hail with برد أصابت حرث قوم ظلموا أنفسهم فأهلكت. It touched and destroyed the farms and the fruits of people completely. وما ظلمهم الله. Allah did not oppress them. They have oppressed themselves. وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَظْلِمُونَ. وَأَخْتُمْ حَدِيثِي. In case the ummah in this ayat was the ummah of Islam or the followers of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, I like you to focus with me on a few ahadith, two hadiths that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَعَدَنِي أَنْ يُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ مِنْ أُمَّتِي سَبْعِينَ أَلْفًا. Allah has promised me, the Prophet is saying, that he will take 70,000 of my ummah to the heaven without being accountable من غير حساب. ويشفع كل ألف منهم لسبعين ألف. And every and each thousand of the 70,000 will make shafa'a intercession to 70,000. ثم يحثو ربي ثلاث حثيات. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take handful of dirt. Numbers of people also on the top of that will go to heaven. That is one narration. And another narration very similar to this
يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: عرضت علي الأمم بالمواسم. I have seen all nations in special seasons. فتراءت علي أمتي ثم رأيتهم فأعجبتني. And then I have seen my nation. My Ummah was the biggest. فملأوا السهل والجبل. They filled the land and the mountains. So many. My Ummah. فأعجبتني كثرتهم وقد ملأوا السهل والجبل. فقال الله: أرضيت يا محمد؟ So then Allah said to me, are you pleased, O Muhammad, with the numbers, the huge number of your ummah, that they will go to heaven? فقال مع هؤلاء سبعين ألفا يدخلون الجنة. Then he said, this is another hadith, very similar, another 70,000 of people will go to Jannah with these people. Who have filled the land and the mountains. وَهُمُ الَّذِينَ لَا يَسْتَرْقُونَ وَلَا يَكْتَمُونَ وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. Their characters, the people who will go to Al-Jannah, اللهم اجعلنا منهم يا رب العالمين. لا يسترقون, they don't rely on الرقية. الرقية is very important, but they don't rely on it. يعني read the Quran on somebody sick. ولا يكتوون, they don't use the fire for sickness. دعاء is better. And توكل على الله is the best. وعلى ربهم يتوكلون, they rely on Allah alone. فقام عكاشة بن محصن, and one of the Sahaba, he heard نبي الله, Prophet of God, is saying this hadith. فَقَالَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ Make dua for me to be one of them. So the Prophet said, أَنْتَ مِنْهُمْ You are from them. You will be among them, O Ukasha. فَقَامَ رَجُلٌ آخَرٌ A man, also from the congregation of As-Sahaba, said, O Prophet of God, also make me dua so I can be one of them. فقال سبقك بها عكاشة. عكاشة already got the dua. So you have to rely on your work now. Those hadith shows the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the mercy of God, and the size of this ummah. يأتي يوم القيامة النبي ومعه الرجل والرجلان. In the day of judgment, some of the prophets will come with their company, and their company will be one person or two. But Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم will come with this kind of number. يوم ندعو كل أناس بإمامهم. Remember when we will call upon people in the day of judgment with their imam, means the imam in this ayah, with their prophet. فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينِهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ Those who got their books with their hand, with their right hands. فَأُولَٰئِكَ يَقْرَؤُونَ كِتَابَهُمْ وَلَا يُظْلَمُونَ فَتِيلًا They will read their books carefully with no oppression. Because I told you before, sometimes the person, and most of the time, person in the day of judgment will have no witness. Why? يوم تشهد عليهم أيديهم وأرجلهم بما كانوا يكسبون. Their hands and their legs will be the witnesses over them in the day of judgment. So, if From here we understand that we are lucky to be from the followers of Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. To be from Ummat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And always to rely on our iman and on our dua. And nobody will be protecting us except our a'mal, our good deeds. Because the person when he goes to Al-Qabr, three things will follow him. Maluhu, wa'amaluhu, wa'waladuhu. Yarji'u ithnan, wa yabqa wahid. Person, when he passed away, goes to the graveyard with the three companions. His family could be with him. His money could follow him somehow. And his deeds. Two of them will come back. They get very busy in this life and they like just to leave the graveyard quickly. They don't like to stay very long over there. Family and money. And only one thing stays in the grave with him is al-amal as-salih. هذا الذي ممكن أن ينفعنا أيها الإخوة. So Allah is saying, do not be like the people who say we are the best. قالوا لن يدخل الجنة إلا من كان هودا أو نصارى. تلك أمانيهم قل هاتوا برهانكم إن كنتم صادقين بلى من أسلم وجهه لله وهو محسن فأولئك لهم أجرهم عند ربهم ولا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. Some people like bad people. I'm not saying all of people are bad of the Christian or of the Jews. Some of them they say nobody shall enter paradise except us. Show us, Allah is saying, your proof that you are good people. بَلَى مَنْ أَسْلَمَ Only those who believe in Allah and those who did good, they will be entering paradise and they will fear nobody and they will be very happy as the Quran said. So we as a Muslims, Allah is telling us that do not claim that you are the people of Al-Jannah. Al-Jannah needs work. Either you are Muslims or not. Nobody shall enter Al-Jannah without good deeds or without Iman at all. أسأل الله العظيم رب العرش العظيم أن يعلمنا ما ينفعنا وأن ينفعنا بما علمنا. O Allah, accept our good deeds. O Allah, make us from those who listen to the truth and follow it. O Allah, make us from the followers of Ummati Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. O Allah, save us in the day of judgment from hellfire. O Allah, make us happy in this dunya and in the hereafter. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وأدخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار بجاهك يا عزيز يا غفار وصل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.